Hi everyone, in today's video I'm going to show you how I display the weather for my current location in the top right corner of my live streams. I edited it a while ago because Jacob asked me where am I and what's the weather like there. This does both. Basically, by entering a check command, the code gets the weather for me based on the location and pops it in the text above. And if I forget to change the location, it'll use whatever I entered last time. To start, you'll need somewhere for the weather and location info to go. In the last video, I added a new scene in OBS called Nested Alerts containing a couple of text sources for the time and date, and a duplicate text source called Source Alerts Weather using the same font style and size so it matches everything else. And I've added some dummy text of what I'd like the weather and location info to look like. In case you missed the last video, you'll find nested alerts within the Cam1 scene and above all the other existing items like the camera. For the next part, follow the link in the description or Google the StreamerBot extension page for weather lookup by location input. Starting from the top, you'll need an API key from weatherapi.com. Follow the link, sign up and log into your account. Weather API has a free plan which you automatically go onto after the trial period. The free plan is more than enough for our needs. Now near the top, click on the copy button for your API key. Then go back to the weather lookup page from earlier. Read through the rest of the page carefully, including the install steps based on your version of StreamerBot. I'm on version 2, so I'm going to expand this arrow for V2. For step 1, my StreamerBot is already open, so I'm going to click on the import button along the top menu, in which a dialog box should also be opened. Back on the weather lookup page, I'm going to save the import file to my desktop. After it's downloaded, drag the file onto the text field for import string, where there should be an importable action called current weather V2. Click on the import button, done. Find and double click on a line that says insert API key here. Then copy and paste the API key from earlier into the value box. You can leave the language default to EN for English or change it later. Steps 8 to 10 were done for me, so do these only if you get an error when compiling the code in step 11. If all goes well, you should see a success message in the compiling log tab. If not, try the compile button again, then save and compile done. But we've only just begun. Have a look through the new action and try to get an idea of what it does, how it works with a check command, then delete it. We're going to replace it with one of modified for our needs. You'll find my code in the description. Copy my code and paste it directly into the import string field like before. After this import, there should now be four new actions. 1, a modified version of the current weather V2 action. 2, an action to set location using a check command, for example, location Sydney. 3, an action which outputs the weather and location info to the text source we set up earlier. This can be run from a timer or another action. And 4, an action that I use to reset stream variables, filters, timers, and more before I start streaming for the day. Anything you want can go into this file. This action can be run from the starting soon sequence. Click on the import button, done. Okay, for the new actions, we have to make a couple of changes. Firstly, for the current weather V2 action, add the API key like before. Then for the show weather action, open execute code, and for line 17, change the code for OBS set GDI text to the scene name and source name of what you have. Remember, we added the source alerts weather text to the nested alerts scene, so both of these have been added to the example code. Fill in the details, then it's onto the commands tab along the top to enable command set location, which should have been added along with the four actions from earlier. Back to the actions tab along the top, select the action for scene starting soon, and for sub actions, right click core actions run action, then select the action starting soon reset before streaming from the drop down box. In an earlier video, we set up a check command to change scenes in OBS to scene starting soon, which can be one part of your starting soon sequence. The other part, as we've just added, can be to reset any variables, filters, etc. If you open the reset code, it currently sets the location to a default value, which you'll want to change to your city or wherever. If you open the execute code for the current weather V2 action, you'll see it only retrieves the info I wanted, which is the temperature in Celsius, Fahrenheit, and location. They're stored into memory as global variables accessible from other actions like show weather, set location, and starting soon reset before streaming. If you look through it, there's lots more weather info available if you can make sense of the code. And if you've been following along with all the other videos in this series, you should be able to use the check command starting to change scenes in OBS to the starting soon scene, which will also do the initial call to the weather API website and output the results into the weather text source from earlier. And if you use the check command cam1, it should change scenes in OBS to the cam1 scene where the nested alert scene is containing the weather and location location info on the top right. As a bonus exercise, currently the weather and location info is retrieved during the starting soon sequence, and that's it. Try to add the code for it to update every 15 minutes or half an hour. Just not too short of an interval, because it can take a while and cause performance issues. And that should do for today's video. If you found it helpful, please like and subscribe for more like this one. In the next video, I'm going to go over all the updated steps of what I do to go live. A quick thank you to these fine folks for supporting the channel, and I'll see you in the next one.